Okay, I've already done this intro twice and had to delete it for various reasons, so I'm going to make this one quick. It's basically my playthrough from the last time, about 2 months ago, hit a stopping point, let's say. It's basically I find out that this game is very difficult to complete solo. Which means that I am going to have to turn the tables a little bit and even the odds here. And the way I'm going to do that is by turning on... It's by turning on God mode. I'm deleting files from my recording drive because I just realized it was full. That could have sucked. Okay. So, I've tried multiplayer, and that didn't work. Well, that worked, but it just wasn't very practical for what I want to do. Basically, I just want to complete this game. I've seen videos of people playing it, and it looks really interesting, and I'm aware that there's a story that you can finish. And when you finish it, it just starts over. So, I want to finish the game. It looks very intriguing to me, and I want to get through it. I want to experience it. So, in order to do that, I enabled... cheats, and now I have God mode. Alright, so I'm going to pause it here, and I'm going to finish this little intro, and then I'm going to disable the mic, because I'm watching stuff, and I got my fan on in the background. I don't want to have the fan blown over the whole playthrough. It's hot in here and everything. So, yeah, I tried joining people's servers, I've tried hosting servers, I've tried just basically trying to get good, essentially, in single player, and I pretty much determined that all those are not practical for me, and I don't know anybody personally that would want to play this with me for a whole playthrough, so I'm just going to do it myself. I'm just going to do a little bit of a cheat through. So, that's it. So I'll be disabling the mic in a sec, and I'll get started. Or continue on, I should say. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. My next guest is a TV star, author, and real-life plane crash survivor. Here to talk to us about his new book, Rescue, along with his son, Timmy. Please, give it up for Eric LeBlanc.
Nice to meet you, man. That's one hell of a story. So let's jump right into it. You've written a harrowing tale of survival and adventure with a plane crash. Look, you can see it on the cover. I feel like you're really blurring the lines here between fact and fiction. Oh, is that the axe? Hey, do y'all want a demonstration? Okay, we've got a setup right over here. Come on, don't leave me hanging. Come on, everyone. All of you want to see this too, right? What do you say? Well, come on, everyone. Yes! All right. Grab Timmy and let's head on over. Watch your step now. I got my axe. Where do you hold this thing? Oh, like this? Here we go. Huh? Is he okay?
Alright, well that was something. I'm gonna see if I can load that save and see if I can do the other ending. Okay. Well, it looks like that one save doesn't count for some reason, so... Yeah, it's not on the list here. Yeah, that sucks. Okay, well, I don't feel like doing all that shit in that facility again. That probably took most of the time today, which is very surprising. So that tells me if you just get the rebreather, you could theoretically complete the game probably within an hour and a half or so. You don't really need the climbing axe too much. Although you would probably need it to get back up if they make you backtrack after you get the artifact and all that. No, I didn't have to get the artifact. I just went to the end there from the computer thing. So really all you need is the rebreather and some good weapons. You could find the machete at the downed helicopter, and that works very well with some teeth thrown on it for some extra kick. Add in some creepy armor if you're good enough to take down a few of those things, and easy peasy. As I say, after I just went through with God mode on, but as far as the choice for the endings, so what I'm guessing the other ending is you shut down the facility, and somehow you either get rescued and you tell the story, or you get rescued and like you don't mention any of that shit, and it's just like, oh yeah, I just survived a plane crash, it was shit was crazy, or you shut down the shit and nobody ever comes and then you just die on the island. I'm guessing those are the other options for the other ending. Maybe I'll look up a YouTube video or something and see if I can find the other ending. But I'm guessing those are the choices for the other endings, where you just kind of ignore the whole situation. And, I don't know. But as far as the decision, so let's look at the options here. You have take down another plane and use one of the children to revive your dead kid. But then you just saw what happened to the other kid that you tried to put in the machine, right? It turned into that freak monster, and then you had to kill it. And the kid didn't look right. So who knows that by reviving the kid with the sacrifice, that your kid would turn out normal. That wouldn't be worth it. Hell, I'd cut my own kid's head off rather than put him in that machine. Or her, or whatever, if I eventually have a kid at some point. So, yeah, I would choose the shutdown. Hands down. Why would you want to put that on the world? That's just completely selfish, obviously. But, I mean, you know, barring PTSD and psychosis and some kind of Stockholm syndrome, who knows what you would be thinking if you had to make that decision, though, if that was real life. I would venture to guess that a few people would probably choose that option, but that most would hopefully choose the shutdown option. It's really the logical choice. It's like, oh, this is a crazy facility. Shut it down. Blow it up. I don't know about blow it up, but definitely some more level-headed scientists should take a look at that. But obviously they did, and it came to the situation that we're in now. But what it seemed to be was that that guy's kid died, the scientist, that Megan girl or whatever. So he put her in the machine with a sacrifice, probably from your downed plane crash. So basically your kid revived his kid, and then his kid got messed up for whatever reason and morphed into that mutant creature, So it didn't work. So reviving dead people, that's probably not a good use of time. So yeah, shut it down. Blow it up. Get rid of it. As far as like where all that shit came from, that's pretty interesting. I wonder if any of the items or cassettes or any of that shit tell you the backstory of any of that stuff. That shit doesn't concern me. You can kind of glean what's happening just from going through the different areas. Obviously some kind of stone was found, and you know where it came from, I don't know, but apparently it turned a bunch of people into freaks, and they tried to use it for other purposes, and it didn't bode well, obviously. But I don't know, pretty interesting. I'm pretty satisfied with the money I paid for it. I got it on sale. I think 60% off, 66% or something. So that's not bad. I got like, I think 10 or 12 hours out of it. So as far as like dollar per hour, that's not very good. But I don't know, I did watch a lot of videos before I finally pulled the trigger on it. And it's weird to see how it's progressed from when it first came out till now. And, yeah. So, that'll conclude my playthrough of The Forest. Unless in the future at some point I get some people together. Maybe I'll do another run through and go for the shutdown ending. But, I'm satisfied with that ending. That was good enough. That's like I told you so ending. I like that. Alright. That's gonna end it for The Forest. Bid thee farewell. Peace out.